When you first walk into the Pro Drum Shop in Los Angeles, it may appear to be like most drum shops you've seen before. There's wall-to-wall gear and no shortage of pictures on the wall. Upon further inspection, however, you may notice that a lot of the pictures are pretty old and can only be found here. That's because unlike a lot of the larger music stores that are scattered around LA, the Pro Drum Shop has something unique. A history. And what better place to have a history in the drumming community than in Los Angeles? Across the street from the Musicians Union, no less.
This is the back office. Not just anyone can come back here now, right?
That's right.
Meet Stan Kiawa. He and his family have run the shop since the 60s.
Started off, my stepfather, Bob Yeager, opened it up in 1959. Used to work at Drum City with Remo Belli, Roy Hart, and he was helping develop and show the various plastic heads that Remo was just starting at that time. This is, I would say, 66, 67, and that's when I came in. I started taking my lessons in 1967 when Bob was dating my mom, hanging out, and I believe we got married in 1970. So my brother and I, we were just hanging out, just still working. Back in the day in the 70s, it was like cartage company guys would come rolling in. That was being when everybody was doing demos and things before machines. There would be a time I'd have a Jeff Porcaro snare drum or Ed Green snare drum or James Gatson snare drum sitting there, just need to flap on a quick head, put a bunch of duct tape on it and shoot it out.
Right.
These guys would run in and run out. Years ago when I was a kid, I was in the office there, and Joe Jones was visiting my stepdad Bob, Papa Joe. He saw me, I was cleaning the heads at the time. It was probably about 68, 69 I think it was. And he goes, "No, Stan, no, you're doing it wrong. It's like this." And he said, "Sit down." So he had me sit out, and he proceeded to finish cleaning the heads for us. It was pretty funny.
Nice. I noticed you have the Buddy Rich kit over there.
Buddy Rich kit is actually my set that at the time I was emulating him in my younger years, and I turned into be a rock and roll kit. I took off that. That Slingman Tom mount, put on the Lubbock mount. That's why that's up there. And when Buddy would be in, called in to do the Johnny Carson show or the Merv Griffin show, they'd fly him out here without his equipment. And at the time, it was a Slingman and Endorsee. And Bob would say, "Stan, pull that head off the wall here," which we did. Stick it on that my drum set, which happened to be the right sizes, and I just go over to the Carson show and set it up for him. And it just turns out that you'd use it 3 or 4 times. And the last gig he played was with Mel Torme at the Palladium. And I set him up for him at that time. It just happened to be the last gig that he played.
So you text for him at his last show?
I was the man that set him up.
Wow.
There's a photo that somebody took off the video just to validate Tom Mount. And this was an El Torme, Tommy Dorsey tribute. Mounts he's wearing, those are practice golf balls that I put on conductor wands for him.
You put golf balls on the conductor wands and he used them to practice?
Those golf balls with the holes in them. And I put some felt around and he'd use them on his... He used to play that triple bass drum setup with orchestras.
Okay.
And special plays. The Steve Gadd one originally back in 86. 5 I think it was. That was a great one. Elvin Jones used to do a lot of Elvin. It was funny. He'd come in here and say, "Stanley, set me up." Set me up means go in the bathroom here and make sure that the vodka or the scotch was sitting right up on top for him. So he'd go in the bathroom and hit a slug and it'd come out here like nothing happened.
This is the archives right here,
this
folks.
This is the archive.
The Pro Drum Shop archive.
It was me and Elvin in one of his set me up, Stan.
Freddie Gruber Drum Clinic.
That's a great show.
Getting the kung fu grip happening even then.
Now, I'm going to just touch the stick.
Louis Belson in-house clinic with a Buddy Rich Louis. That's a great show. That's a great show. That's a great show. Well,
There's definitely something cool about being in a place where drumming in Los Angeles basically grew up over the last four decades. House of Drumming would like to thank Stan and everyone else at the Pro Drum Shop for taking the time to share with us. I'm Steve Holmes for houseofdrumming.com.